I am out of breath and out of money. And you wanna know why? Because I just purchased a small collection of comic books and unopened and opened Marvel trading cards. And I'm excited. I ran into a lady who cleans out houses, and somebody's mother told this lady to take them or she's throwing them in the garbage. And there's some good stuff in here. Unopened wax boxes of Marvel. Not to mention the comic books. So we're gonna see what the heck we got. This video isn't gonna be long enough, so I'll split it up into multiple videos. So stay tuned. Woo! All right, I'm here at my storage unit, and I got this cart full of the collection I just bought of some comic books and a ton of comic trading cards. So we're gonna go through some of this now. Obviously, we're not gonna get to all of it, but you'll see it when I do, because I haven't even looked through 3/4 of this stuff yet. So let's see what I got. We'll end up stacking it here on the empty table and see how we do, huh? Yeah. Oh, geez. And excuse my roughness here. So we do have some Star Wars books in the front of this one. You know, I gotta see what's going on here. Midnight Suns, Savage Dragon. There's a lot of independent Image in here also. Got a box of Batman packs. These are all open by the looks of things. Although, what's in here is not Batman. It looks like Marvel metal. Some unopened, uncut sheets. That's kind of cool. And there is a bunch of, looks like, 1994 Marvel Universe cards in this box. We got Thor. Anyways, like I said, I don't have time to go through everything. That was a little misleading. I thought it was going to be an unopened box of cards. This is cool. This is a unopened box of Mortal Kombat. Mortal Kombat. This is hot right now. Super hot. Let me see if I can get a better angle here. So yeah, unopened box of Mortal Kombat. This is probably $150 at least, I would assume, unopened. Seeing how the movie is extremely hot right now. Mystery brown bag. This feels like another box of cards. Oh, look at that. A second box of Mortal Kombat unopened. Sweet. Here's another mystery brown bag of cards. This one's a little bigger. What's in here? Oh, look at this. Two boxes of Amazing Spider-Man flare cards. These are from 1994. Right now, these are so hot. Marvel trading cards. Two boxes of unopened Spider-Man Marvel trading cards. This one, this is a good one right here. Look at this. 1994 Flare inaugural edition Marvel trading cards. These are also, I think, from 1994. I believe these go for over $400 a box. I gotta look it up. That's sweet. Unopened. There's another mystery bag right here. Mystery bag. Gotta love mystery bags. Two unopened boxes of X-Men Premier Edition Flair Trading Cards, 1994 Flair Ultra. Now, the only thing with the Ultras, you got to be careful because they are glossy and they tend to stick together in the packs. So I'm going to leave these unopened. You never know what you're going to get with the Flair Ultra glossy cards. But hey, another two boxes, brand new, unopened. Here's a third box of Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man. This one's cool. This is a 1994 Power Rangers unopened box. Another mystery bag. What's in there? It'd be nice to find some 1990 Impel Marvel trading cards. I don't know what these are. These are more 94 Flair Marvel cards. We have Valiant, a box of Valiant cards. Unopened, Valiant. I don't know much about Valiant cards. These are also 93. So it looks like a partial box. There's probably 20 packs here of the Valiant. I would say probably 3/4 of this collection is all comic cards, and then there's several boxes of comics that I haven't went through yet. Got this mystery box here. Some vintage Mad magazines. Well, that's kind of cool. This is a 1979 Captain America sticker, I think. 1979 Hulk sticker. People like the vintage stuff right here. Those are kind of neat. I don't know much about those. I'll have to look those up. Box of plastic sleeves, early 90s plastic sleeves, comic card binder. Looks like more of the Flair Ultra cards from 94. Got a whole binder full of them. And they're all in good condition. There's like, it looks like they came right out of the pack and into the binder. In this one. Star Trek trading cards. What's that? And a little uncut sheet of 95 Flair Ultra. That's really cool. That'd look cool framed. But this is just a binder of Star Trek. Oh, well, there is some Oh yeah, these are all Star Trek 3. And these are from 1993. A little bit of mix of everything in here. But those are some cool portrait cards. This one's labeled Batman. Yeah, these are Batman comic cards. Right here. Joker. It's kind of cool. A lot of binders. There's a lot of binders here. Here we go. What are these? What year are these Marvel cards? 1992 Marvel. These are all in really good shape. I would say near mint to mint. Impel 92 Marvel. So we're getting there. We gotta find those 1990. But the 92 ones are cool. Unless it was 91. Maybe these are the series 2. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. Whole book of 92 Impel cards. Probably $200 there, I would say, in today's market. Got a peach folder here. Never know what you're gonna get. What is this stuff? Just looks like a Valiant postcard. Look at that. Beavis and Butthead uncut sheet. and a nice uncut sheet of Marvel masterpiece cards. That's a cool Green Goblin. Oh yeah, look at that, it's two of them. I got Venom, Thanos, War Machine, Silver Surfer. That's a good uncut sheet right there, Marvel masterpiece cards. And then we got like a mix of cards here. There's a Deadpool, a couple Deadpool cards. These are from Skybox 93, I think, 1993. Marvel cards are so hot right now. Sandman cards. Sorry about the lighting in here, it's not great. It's a cool Venom on there, if you can see that. More Marvel uncut sheets in the back. I got this other bin here. Brown box. Let's see what's in this brown box. Looks like more cards. I got this. This is a cool Incredible Hulk card with a little mug offer on the back. It's Incredible Hulk 111, 1979. That'd be cool. There's some other vintage cards in here. What are these? These are old Kiss cards. 1978 Kiss cards. These aren't in perfect shape. They're probably good condition, if anything. If you guys are into Kiss, I've never seen these before, but these are pretty cool. Got some Star Trek The Next Generation holograms. I don't know much about those. 1992 Impel Star Trek. There's another one. Sweating here, hot in this place. Star Trek, looks like a Romulan ship, possibly. Cruiser. Klingon, sorry. This is a cool Batman foil card. That one's 1994. Another one. Guess it goes this way. It's another Star Trek. And another Batman foil card. Those are kind of neat. Neat little box there. More binders. Whatever this is. Looks like a complete story thing going on here. I don't even know what these are. Not familiar with that. Okay, next. Probably worth $1 million for all I know. Another binder. Oh, this one, comic books. I don't think I've ever seen comic books in a binder before. We got Batman number 492, 659. The binder's a little funky. It doesn't exactly line up. So these books aren't gonna really stay on the pages on the binder. These are all Batman books. Trying to get a good look at some of them. 661, Detective Comics, 495, 663. There's a Bane. Looks like that's the one where Batman gets his back broken, 497. There's another Bane, 664, Detective Comics. Two-Face comic, Nightfall, number 13. Interesting. Nice, get a look at that real quick. Like I said, I don't have time to really go through all these now. It's a cool book of Batman. And these look to be in at least near mint condition. Blue binder here. These are Marvel cards. I got a Moon Knight. God, the lighting's horrible. What year are these? These are a Skybox, 1993. So I got Deadpool, Cannonball, Apocalypse, Cable. There's a whole binder of 93 Impel Marvel cards, all in near mint to mint condition. There's another binder here. Like I said, you guys are seeing this when I do. These are all Valiant cards. I don't know a whole lot about Valiant besides Bloodshot, which I believe he's in here. So, got a mystery, another mystery box. What's in this one? This looks like, all right, what do we got? This is a wedding album for X-Men. I don't think it's a 1963. Mystery Incorporated, book one. Yeah, I don't think they would charge $1.95 in 1963, but yeah, book one. The Crusaders, the Ark, Hard Corps, the Spawn, 22. This one looks kind of cool. This is a Marvel Year in Review, 1993. Bring on the bad guys. It does have Venom on the cover. That's kind of a cool book. Take that off of there. There it is. Never seen that one before. And then this is a cool Spider-Man. Marvel Presents Spider-Man Magazine. First issue. A lot of comic books that are, looks like they're kind of damaged. They're not in the best shape in here. Some X-Men. Superman, Batman magazine. There could be anything in here. The comic cards is probably where the money is on some of this stuff. Superman, Batman. Number one guide to comic cards. Got a Aliens Under Siege, Batman Sword of Azrael. Interesting. And then we got this Marvel Masterpiece Captain America tin, and it's got a lot of the characters on the side, and then some open cards on the inside. Another box of stuff here. Got some more flare cards in this box. More cards there. Looks like some Batman and Robin cards. We got a Wild Star number one. For some reason, they felt the need to put it in one of these strong cases, which I don't believe that holds a lot of value. It's kind of cool. This is a Star Wars sketchbook. Joe Johnston. It's not in that good of shape. There's a lot of wear on the back, but this is pretty cool though. What year is this one? This looks pretty old. 1977. Star Wars sketchbook. Cool. A lot of the ships and stuff in here. It's pretty awesome. More cards. These guys definitely collected 1994 Marvel Universe cards. I'm not going to go open these up right now. Like I said, it'd be nice to get the 1991 or 1990, whatever that first series is. Some more Marvel cards. Got a whole case of those. Another box. A couple of binders that say Spawn cards on there. I didn't know they made Spawn cards, but oh, okay, these aren't Spawn cards. I'll just open this up right there in the front. Spawn number one. That's really cool. Spawn number one. Spawn number two. Spawn number three. Number four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. That's a good one. 10, 12. This is Spawn 1 through 15. that was unexpected. That's probably at least a 9-6 Spawn comic right there, that number one. That was an unexpected find. I was expecting cards. What about this one here? These are cards. Valiant. These are all more Marvel cards. Marvel. It's Valiant cards in the back. Black binder. Spider-Man Powers trading cards. These are 1994 Spider-Man Powers. Oh, there's other characters in here too, but a lot of Spider-Man. Nova, Human Torch, Venom, Carnage. Probably got a Carnage rookie card. More Star Trek cards there. See that? There's a cool book. Look at this one. Another box of cards. Look at this. Another box of X-Men flare cards, unopened. The third. Here we go. This is an unopened Skybox Batman. Batman box. Limited edition. It's numbered right here. They only made 266,000 of these. Limited edition. More cards. What's this here? Deathmate. It's in here. Open or not opened? Opened. Okay. Miss Doubtfire. Well, it's a Deadpool card. Oh, there's some vintage Muppet cards in here. Wow. I gotta go through all these boxes. X-Men Series 2 trading card 10. There's the cards inside. This box is full of cards. Whoa. Whole stack of Spider-Man Marvel cards. Star Trek. More cards in here. Iceman. Some plastic sleeves. More, that's a cool card. Star Trek cards. lot of these are in holders. It's a Wildcats foil card. Here's a 91 hologram card. 91 Impel of Magneto. It's cool. The year I'm looking for, really. That one. Not exactly sure why they put them in the cases. Just because they're in cases doesn't necessarily mean they're worth money. X-Men. This is a promo card of Zen. Zen promo card. Some Star Trek. '94 Flair. Baseball cards. Interesting. Wasn't expecting any baseball cards to be in here. You guys know me and baseball cards. These are all really rough. I would not think, got some 70s baseball. These aren't in good shape at all. I doubt there's anybody really good in here. I'm not gonna go through these right now as much as I want to. This box is just completely full of cards, of Marvel cards. They're all in these cases. Some were Flair. A bunch of Star Treks. I wonder if these are the complete sets. This one's really cool. This one, look at that Carnage card. That's cool. This is a 1994 Carnage. That's a really cool card. That Hobgoblin is really cool. Dr. Octopus. It's like a holographic. I don't know what that is, but there it goes, on the ground. Gotta drop at least one. This is full of cased cards, so they felt the need to put these in holders, and I certainly don't have time to go through all these right now. Maybe we'll do this in another video. All right. There's that Beast. We'll do a couple. These are all Flair Ultra. Flair Ultra cards. These were, ooh, that's cool. This is a 92 Venom hologram. That's really sweet. And a Thing hologram. Nice, these are nice. Wolverine hologram, 1992. This is another Venom and a Ghost Rider. Wow. I got these comic books here. Like I said, you guys will see him when I do. This is an old Batman book, 20 cent Batman. Number 253. Brave and the Bold, 123. It's a Super Family. The lighting's miserable in here. Marvel Team Up, 25 cent book. Spider-Man, Iron Man. It's an old Star Trek TV guide. Lois Lane, number 127. Marvel Tales 53. Masters of Kung Fu number 20. Hands of Shang-Chi, yay. Avengers Marvel Triple Action number 20. Looks like an Archie book, maybe. Madhouse. Spooky. Ghostly Tales. Superboy. Legion of Superheroes, Superboy. Huh. Amazing Spider-Man number 158. That's cool. Dr. Octopus on the cover. Oh, look at this. Amazing Spider-Man 164. Nice. Hey, who's got a sad sack? Huh? Archie. There's a... Oh, this one's in crappy condition. 80, number 80, my Iron Man. Ooh, Captain America and Falcon, number 177. Some of these are in really rough shape. They got pieces of the cover missing. Captain Marvel, 41. That's a shame. Justice League, number 108. Sergeant Fury, 139. Conan, Barbarian, number 12. Batman, number 248. That one's missing the whole magazine. Living Vampire, number 23. I think I've seen this one as one of the hot books. Astonishing Tales, Deathlock, number 25. I think that is a key book. Origin of the most offbeat superhero. So that's the origin of Deathlock. This is a cool looking Detective Comics. Look at that, Batman on the front cover. Number 431, that's nice. Kazar 5. Kid Colt, Gunslinger. Human Torch number 1, that's cool. Another Batman 269. Frankenstein Monster number 12. Detective Comics 454. Hunchback of Notre Dame. Jimmy Olsen 156. Jimmy Olsen 157. 155. 154. 162. 163. Star Trek Gold Key with Spock and Kirk on the cover. It's an Archie book. Marvel's Greatest Comics. Fantastic Four 150. Nice. Doctor Strange number 3. That one's in pretty rough shape. Go through a few more of these comics. We got some more Classic Illustrated, a bunch of those. Oh man, this one's in horrible shape. This is too bad, too bad. This is really, really rough. Fantastic Four, 112, really rough shape. Well, it's better to have it than not have it, right? I actually have another copy of this. Hulk vs. Thing, it's really bad. More Classic Illustrated. Web of Spider-Man 117. And last but not least, I have a long box. Long box of comics. These look like all DC. Some backer boards. Bunch of Batman books. I'm not gonna have time to show all these. I'll show a couple here. Batman Adventures, Batman Spawn. A couple of Batman Spawns. Three of them. Four. Look like the books. Batman Riddler, Two-Face, Grendel. World's Finest. Batman Sword of Azrael Book 2. Justice League Task Force. Batman Death in the Family 429. It's another Batman 455. 457, 494, 495, 500, 501, 505, 506, 507, 508, and 511. Some Detective Comics for 589, 650, 51, 661, 662. 662. I always thought that was a cool cover with Frankenstein and the Mummy. It's the newsstand edition. That's cool. 672, 73, 74, 75, 676. People talking in here. Just a bunch of Detective Comics there. Legends of the Dark Knight. Looks like a Halloween edition. That's kind of a cool cover. Dark Knight with the Joker. Just flipping through these. A reprint, I believe. They're too good to be the real thing, but there's a couple of reprints of Action Comics number one. So even these hold a little bit of value. But they're probably worth about $15 to $18 a piece. Supergirl number one. Steel number one. Superman Man of Steel number 30. We got a sealed Death of Superman book. Looks like two of them. Superboy number one. That's cool. Superman Speeding Bullets. Batman on the cover. Green Lantern number 46. Superman 75. Opened. Just a bunch more Superman books here. Superman. That's kind of a cool cover. A little foil cover. Death of Superman. This is the last bunch in there without really going through them all. Another Adventures. Bunch of Adventures of Superman. There's a Superboy, a couple of those. Nice foil cover there. Adventures of Superman 505. Action Comics 680, 695. Action Comics 687. couple of those. 687, Man of Steel, 22. Several of those. There's another one. It's like a connecting cover or something on that one. Number 30. Black Orchid, Death Gallery, DC Vertigo, Metal Men, Sandman number 50, Spectre, That's it, guys. That's what I got. The money's in the Marvel cards, I think, right now. So I have some work to do. But I gotta figure out how I'm gonna do with all this stuff. I'm sure there's some hidden gems in here that we didn't really have time to go through today. But I appreciate you guys sticking around and going through this with me, seeing what I got. Till next time, guys. Thanks for watching, as always. Take care.